Keys definitely first will be defense. I think we always stress that every single year. Defense is always our number one priority. I think also just leadership, communication. I think we have some younger players that I think can really step up for us, but we need that leadership to get them there, to let them know the situation that we're going to be in, the expectations. But I'm really excited for this year. I think it'll be good.
X's and O's wise, what are some of the things that really stand out to you about these KDEVs?
I think this year our shooting is going to be really, really exceptional. We've been working on that a lot in open gym, so I think that'll be a big key for us that maybe you guys haven't noticed in the past years that I think will really show up this year.
For you to be looked at as one of the leaders of this team, what are some of the things that you're going to be stressing to some of the underclassmen that, you know, don't have the SAC Friday night, Saturday night experience that you guys have?
I think just the intensity of every game, and no matter who you're playing, like every single game, you have to show up, you have to really just work hard every game. I think sometimes when you're younger, you're like, oh, we play a certain team, and it just, like, just you get down sometimes. I think the intensity really and the focus, I think that's the key for these younger kids.
You know, with Shania graduated and with Solaire now at Homestead, there's going to be an emphasis on finding players to score a little bit more on a given Friday night or a given Saturday. Who are going to step up as scorers for this Concordia team? Obviously, you guys like to keep games in the 30s, 40s, low 50s if you can, but who's going to put in the baskets for Concordia this year?
I think distributions from everyone will happen. I think we're not really worried about the past and who we lost. I think we're just worried about the future and what that holds, and we're just really excited for that.
What are some of the biggest keys for Concordia as we enter 2017-2018?
We've got a nice nucleus of veteran players, but it's going to have to be some young kids that really develop and come along as the season goes.
When you take a look at, obviously, Shania graduated. She's been such a big part of the program the last few years. Solaire Stark's now at Homestead. Who are some of the names and some of the players that you expect to step into bigger roles? Obviously, Carissa's going to be a leader for you guys, but who are some of the players you're expecting to play bigger roles this year?
Well, Carissa will be, I think, a lot more of a coach on the floor this year. And then Libby Hetler's a four-year varsity player. Paige Patterson's a four-year varsity player. So those two, and they're great people. They'll be great leaders for us. Work ethic is wonderful. So those three are a really good nucleus for us.
With Paige and Libby, that's a little bit of height, is it not? Or am I wrong about that?
Yeah, Libby's 5'10", 5'11". So, yeah.
Are you guys going to play kind of inside out then? Or how does that impact what you do based on the personnel you have?
Libby's really extended her range, so we're really happy about that. So that's going to help us a lot. That'll give her more flexibility and the team more flexibility. So we're looking forward to that. We've got Nautica Rogers that's coming back off of an ACL tear, and hopefully she'll be ready to go. She's a junior. She'll really help us. Her athleticism, quickness is really going to be a help to us, both ends of the floor.
When you take a look at just the overall SAC, what do you guys have to do to compete for an SAC championship, which is the goal at Concordia every year?
Well, I'll tell you what, it's top to bottom, very difficult conference. We were just naming off five or six schools that are very, very good, and then everybody else you have to be ready for also. So we just got to get better every day. Start where we're at and get better every day.